Suppose there are times when you lose your troubled mind. Suppose there are times when you're feeling fine. Suppose there are days when your colors turn to gray. That's when you call me and know just what to say. We go out in the night. We jump and touch the light. We dance and we don't sleep until we die. We don't have to worry. Drink up the light, it's early. Keep dancing, 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 running right. Never thought I'll say it, but yes, the Maruti Ritz does have quite a nice driving experience. Hello everyone, welcome back to another video on the JRS Cars YouTube channel. In today's video, I have a car from Maruti Suzuki that when it was launched, created quite a splash in the market. Yes, I am talking about this car, the Maruti Ritz. Fun fact, this car was actually called the Maruti Suzuki Splash, or rather the Suzuki Splash, and Suzuki decided that this name will not work for a car in India and hence called it the Ritz. Maybe they were inspired by the Ritz-Carlton or whatever. Anyway, the Ritz is the name we got for this car. This car was launched way back in 2009, and when it came, it made quite an impact in the market. Maruti was known for cars like the Swift, the SX4 and the Eco and the Omni. Cars that were plain and basic and got their purpose solved. This car with its really tall boy design, the boomerang shape at the back, really made quite an impact in the market. These cars are available for as low as 3 lakhs. Is this car worth your money, especially when you compare it to the used car alternatives, Titan or even the Santro? Let's find out in this video. Alright guys, considering the age and market of this car, let's not spend too much time on design and focus on the points that really matter. From the front, this car does look quite nice. We have a nice tall boy stance, and after driving this car, you really do have a nice high driving position to ensure you have good visibility all round. We have nice headlights in the front, your fog lights down below. This being the top spec ZXI petrol, we have these good looking 14 inch wheels. From the side profile, you can really see the tall guy looks of this car, looks quite nice. And as we move to the back, we get this polarizing boomerang rear shape lights. Yes, when this car came out, a lot of people criticized this for its like half back design, half boot design. I don't know what Maruti was thinking. It's like as the designers came all the way to here and they started, well, let's just draw a line like that. Anyway, that's what we got with the Ritz. However, 11 years later in design, this car does look quite nice. And yes, it is different when you compare it to other cars on the road. Opening the boot, as you guys can see, boot space is not that great. However, for a fun little city car, this car has enough space to take on any weekend road trip anywhere. You also get this really nice spoiler at the back, looks quite nice. We get the ZXI ABS badging, showing that Maruti did have some focus on safety in those days. Especially when you compare it to cars like the Santro. Anyway, moving inside, as you guys can see, the opening is quite good. Get inside. And once you do get inside, you are sitting on a throne. I mean, look at the height difference between the front seat and the back seat. Wow. You have plenty of headroom. I am 6 foot tall. The front seat has been pushed all the way in the front. I have ample leg room. Under the support too is not that bad, but not that great, I must say. This driver's seat is set to my driving position. And as you guys can see, you do have plenty of space at the back over here. Overall, for a small city car, this car is definitely more practical in terms of space when you compare it to the Swift, especially if you forgive it for its tall boy design and weird looking back end. Let's move to the front. Before we check out the dashboard, let's quickly open the engine bay. And there we guys have it, the 1.2 litre K-series heart of the Ritz. This is pretty much the same engine you got in the Swift at the time, the 1.2 K-series, producing 85 bhp and 113 Nm of torque. This vehicle does feel quite punchy at low revs, and this vehicle was available with the 1.3 DDIS, and yes, I'm yet to review that engine, maybe in an upcoming episode. Anyway, moving back inside. As you guys can see, the interiors of this car are really futuristic. We have the pop-up tachometer over there, we have this cool red colored combination over here. Not sure if that was part of the red color car or because this was the ZXA variant. Anyway, looks quite cool. We have the matching red color checkered square finish over here. Anyway, we have your typical Maruti switchgear, your window controls, mirror controls, a small door pocket as well. Please jump inside. As you guys can see, wow, this is the feeling of sitting in a Ritz. I mean, look at the amount of headroom I have. Literally anybody, even 7 foot tall people will fit here quite comfortably. Let's start the car. We get these Mini Cooper style lights and a speedometer. Yes, this car is so silent you can hardly hear it running. Hard to think that this car comes from the same manufacturer as that car as well. Anyway, the most cool feature of the Maruti Ritz has to be its pop-up tachometer. Really a cool feature, something that is available only on the VXI and the ZXI. Anyway, talking about instrument cluster, it's simple, clean and basic. We have a massive speedometer, your telltale lights are placed around it. We have your average fuel economy, your range, your odometer. This car has done 57,000 kilometers, as you guys can see. Yeah, so basically a small display over there. We get your old school music system, looks pretty old school and basic. AC controls, you have a cool shifter knob over here, feels quite nice to use. Your handbrake down below. You have a manual adjustment for a mirror. You have your interior lights, visors of course. You have a small storage space over here as well as a glove box underneath. Overall, this car is quite nice, even though it does seem quite basic. It has all what you require for comfortable transportation in this modern day and age. And at the price these used Ritz are available at, you really can't go wrong with this car. However, how does this car drive? Does it really live up to the reputation? Let's find out right now. Alright guys, driving the Suzuki Ritz. Wow, this car really does feel very sprightly to drive. The 1.2 K series, when you compare it to the old G13B engine, yes, it was a bit down on its tunability and absolute outright performance. However, this engine is much more drivable, as you guys can see, second gear, just around 2000 RPM in second gear with the AC on. This car is really a very comfortable car to drive. The clutch is light and easy. The steering does feel a bit more heavy than what I would have expected. Probably this was one of the last generation of sporty hydraulic steerings, I guess, for the car. Anyway, the mirrors give you good coverage. You have massive visibility out the front. Back too, you get good visibility through the boomerang rear windshield, and there we have another Ritz over there. I was thinking that this is actually quite a rare car. However, the day I came to review this car, I've seen like already 5 or 6 Ritzes around me. So probably may not be that rare. Anyway, so this car does have a nice modified horn, or should I say updated horn, can't really call it a modification. What else can I say guys, for around 3 to 3.5 lakhs, a good condition. This car is I think 2015 or 2016 I believe. Suspension is in good condition, everything feels good. And yes, this car does not feel as dated as it's supposed to feel. I mean, come on, 2009 is actually quite far behind us right now. Anyway, let's quickly off the AC. We are now currently in second gear. Okay, we have some curves in the front, so we cannot give any acceleration runs. Really very sharp as well. As usual, we have disc in the front, a drum at the back. However, this car really, this car is basically a Maruti Swift that has a tall boy design on it. So it's really quite dynamically good. You feel exactly what you want to feel. Steering is quite communicative, like I said. Throttle response is really very good. And with the AC off, you can really enjoy this car. Yes, 85 bhp and 130 Nm of torque does not seem much when you compare it to modern standards. However, this car is quite light and the spin off of that is, it really is quite fun to drive. Going full throttle now. Does feel quite good. Let's see if this car passes the through gap testing. Let's see, will it pass in this gap? Yes. As you guys can see, advantage of a small city car. Pickup is really quite good. The car feels eager. And I mean, for 3 lakhs, you can get probably a new Alto or a Quid or something like that. Yes, those cars are new cars, but then this again is a used Maruti. What can go wrong with the used Maruti? Absolutely nothing. So yes, if you ask me, should you buy a new car or a used Ritz? Well, I would definitely say to consider the Ritz if you're looking for a Swift or a Wagoner or a Swift or an i10 or something like that. This car is quite spacious. It has the Maruti badge. And yes, while the looks at the back can be a bit polarizing, with this car's age, you do get used to it. And this car does look quite, really very good. I would say it's interesting and definitely makes for a quirky buy, if you ask me. I mean, if Doug Demero was watching this, let's hope he reviewed a Suzuki Splash when it was there. Because really, this car does have a lot of quirks, especially when you compare it from a brand like Maruti, which is known for its very conservative designs. Let's say quick overtake right now. No, we have an ETS driver like that. Okay. Pickup is really quite good with this car. Never thought I'll say it, but yes, the Maruti Ritz does have quite a nice driving experience for a city car. Of course, on the highway, maybe around 120 to 140 would be where the stability limits of this car would be reached because of its tall body design. However, for the regular commute, the clutch is light and easy, the gear shifts are smooth, the engine is really responsive, headlights are nice and powerful, as you guys can see. So yeah, overall a great car, a great buy, and one that I would definitely recommend. Even with the AC on, performance is quite sprightly. And like I mentioned, this car does have enough performance for the daily city commute and even the occasional weekend drive on the highway. So guys, if you like this video, do give the video a thumbs up, take a second to subscribe, and definitely share this video with your friends if any of your friends are looking to buy a used car in the 3 lakh segment, and maybe they have not looked at this car, or maybe you think this car would fit them. Definitely do share this video with them. And big ups to my friend Narayanan for giving me his car to drive. And yeah, he just recently picked up this car and is really enjoying it as well. So kudos to him for giving me his almost brand new car for this review. With that, I'll see you next video. Thank you so much, guys. And yeah, I'll see you next video really soon. Take care, bye bye, drive safe.